Hey guys, so here's a little video on the new mower. Got it on Tuesday, today's Saturday. Let's see there, that's 4.3 hours I've got on it now. So it's a Gravely ProTurn 48. There's the Gravely ProTurn 148. The slight differences are the Kawasaki engine. So this is the FS. I think the 148 comes with the FX engine. The major difference that I can see is this is where the air filter is in here. So whereas the FX engines have like one where you pull out like out of a barrel type one. One fuel tank as well. That's whereas the 148's got the dual fuel tanks. So I think that's actually it's a bit of a flaw in this machine. Now they've got this tank here, it's just a waste of, you know, wasted space basically. I mean, I don't know how hard it would have been to, or how much extra it would have cost to put another tank in there. You know, most of the machines do it that way anyway, but that's just one of the ways, I guess, it's why it's cheaper to go this way. So that's, you can see there though, it's considerably bigger on that side with the fuel tank than that side. But anyway,
after using it for a few days, or you know, a few jobs and stuff, it's a lot different to what I'm used to. Obviously the size being the biggest thing. I've only had 36s before, this is a 48, so there's a huge difference in the size of the deck. I have got a OCDC, the deck block, the chute blocker on order, so I'm just waiting for that to turn up. I've had this down a couple of times to mow with. It does a good job, so yeah, I'll be interested to see the results with the chute blocker on there after I get it. I think one of the good things is the accessibility to the belts. You can see there, it's just a matter of flipping that up. It's quite simple. Just the control panel, it's pretty straightforward, just similar to every other one. Well, other thing too, this has got a handbrake, so that's off there, that's on. Some of the other zero turns that I've used, they actually, you pull these out, pull the levers out into a slot that is basically like the park brake. These don't have that at all. This does. Doing that is nothing. That's just to get out of the way of, or get them out of the way so you can hop on and off the machine. I'm yet to decide on what I'm going to do with the anti-scalp rollers. So they're at the lowest setting at the moment, which I think is the high, basically for high cuts. I think the lower you want to cut, which typically I will be doing in Australia, we cut it a fair bit lower. So you can see there, like yesterday, that's on there, that is on, it's actually on 1.75 inches, so which is relatively low. I would typically like to cut it higher than that, but the lawns I was cutting, it needed to be that low. But yeah, that's different types of grasses. In Australia, typically you can see this lawn here, so that's cut, I think that's cut at about 2 inches, what this is here. That all looks, you know, that's pretty nice. Yeah, mate.
Can I have a look at the picture?
Yep.
Oh.
Yeah, it's empty. We need to put some more in it, don't we? So you can see there's a fuel gauge there. It's on the empty side. Yeah, I'm still sort of getting used to the engine. There's a few different, just the way it sounds, the way it looks. It is substantially different aesthetically as opposed to the FX engine. You can see there the exhaust is down there. It's a different looking exhaust. I actually wore both my exhausts out on the FX engine in not very many hours. Like the Skag, I think, had 300 and something hours, and it actually had a hole in it. Same with the Hustler engine, same type of exhaust like the FX Kawasaki engines have. So yeah, I'd be interested to see how that goes. I mean, I don't think I could be any worse, basically. And they're quite expensive to replace. I replaced one on the Hustler and it was about $600 or something to replace it. So, yeah, it's not a cheap exercise doing that. Apart from that, I really like the colour. I like the look of it. It feels really sturdy and strong when you're on it as well. Like any commercial machine, I guess you can just feel the difference in the quality. But yeah, I think... hopefully it's going to be a good machine. I'm happy with the deck and actually the finish of the cut so far. It's a wrong sort of type of time of season to be really getting to know how it's going to finish on the longer grasses and stuff, but I've got a few jobs coming up in the next couple of weeks that will give me a good indication of that. One good thing too is the actual deck belt is not like a V-belt like all the other ones I've ever used. So there's sort of
only one way, or not, there's, you know, it's easy to get it on and work out which way it's going to go. But a little tip, guys, is to take a photo of it, of the way the belts go, so you can go back to it and
when you break one and put it on quite easily.
I mean, it's easy to figure out, I suppose, but, you know, it can save you a few minutes here and there, and it all adds up at the end of the day.
Yeah, everything else is pretty straightforward on it. I'm sure most of the people watching this have probably seen it all before. Tyres, they're pretty aggressive, but they're brand new, so that's to be expected. So I'm just got to be really careful on my turns that I'm not sort of ripping them backwards and you know, trying to tear it up. I think the biggest thing I struggle with, and I think everyone struggles with in Australia, well, is the shorter lawns, the rougher looking lawns where there's a fair bit of dirt. Any sort of abrasive stuff on the dirt's gonna rip it up. But you know, the nicer lawns like this one, you couldn't tear this one up. So the hanging system's pretty similar. I was actually expecting it to be different. I think this I'm not sure whether this is a 2014 model. I think it might be, because I think the 2015s come out with a different hanging system. I think that was one of the main difference, but it all looks pretty similar, I guess. It's actually hanging from, it's hanging here from the chains, so it's pretty straightforward to adjust it if it gets out. Hopefully it won't. So overall, so far so good. I'm really happy with it. Just be interested to, you know, once I get the hang of it and, you know, to see how it actually improves time-wise some of my bigger jobs. The biggest downside, I guess, compared to the Skag is just it is, because it's a much bigger machine in overall size. I mean,
there's only 6 inches either side with the deck, so a foot in total. Difference. It's just a lot bigger, so, and because of the tires, I'm not sort of as aggressive in my turning and stuff like that yet.
So I'm just still getting used to that. So whether I don't think I'd be losing time with it at the moment, but I'm probably not any faster than I was on the Skag. The Skag was a super quick machine and really easy to turn and get around without making too much mess of the lawn. So I think it, you know, all my bigger jobs and stuff, which I am getting a lot more of, like literally today I got a new client. It's a that is now my biggest job. It was a $200 mower, so getting this bigger mower, is already that job in itself will sort of pay for the mower over time. So yeah, as I've said before, I'm tending to the clients I seem to be getting now are bigger lots, so the bigger mower's warranted, I think. All right, guys. Any questions? I'm more than happy to answer it. The other main difference between the ProTurn 148 and the ProTurn 48
is the seat. I think the 148 comes with the new air ride seat, which is really comfortable. But I tried another zero turn in the dealer, and its seat was like rock hard. So the seat in this thing isn't too bad. So looking forward to, as I said, getting some more hours on it and getting used to it and putting it through its paces, especially once I get the chute blocker. I still feel really not concerned isn't the right word, but cautious, I guess, without having something to block things if needed. I like that sort of security, peace of mind, that when you're in your rocky area or whatever, you can just flip it down and away you go. But all right, so that's the ProTurn 48 commercial Gravely. I love the front badge on this. I think it looks awesome, looks tough and looks well built, and I'm really happy with it. All right, guys.